A very good afternoon, dear. Welcome to the program Talking Politics, where we normally discuss issues that had to do with the political development in Nigeria. I am Alhassan Bala. Today we are actually going to look at the issue of election budget, because it's something that has been going on a feud between the National Assembly and the presidency over the election budget, where the INEC as well as a lot of stakeholders now is actually the issue is micro-run among the stakeholders. Everybody is commenting, urging the both sides to shield the sword and ensure sweet budget. Recently, senators and members of the House of Representatives had disagreed over the component of the budget for the 2019 general elections, which should be approved. The election budget is the total amount of 182.2 billion naira, which the presidency sent to the National Assembly, and actually the two chambers of the National Assembly disagreed recently, but finally the two chambers, more especially the Senate, have agreed to actually reconvene before the September 27th to consider the issue of the election budget, but with less than 6 months to this election. And INEC need a lot of money. INEC need this money to buy a lot of things that will be used for this election. How possible this will happen? How possible that this issue of feud between the presidency and the National Assembly will not affect the 2019 general election? How is it possible? On this note, I'm going to discuss this issue of the election budget with the public affairs analysts as well as stakeholders on the issue of election, who happens to be actually a member of civil society organization monitoring group that normally monitor election or observed election in different states, and who also do that in 2019 election. That is Mr. Jide Ojo. Welcome to Talking Politics.
It's a pleasure. Thanks for having me. Good afternoon. Back at the cellar.
Thank you. I wish you well. Yeah. Well, this issue of election budget. Firstly, let's begin with the amount. It's about 100 and something billion naira budgeted for this election. It's not too much.
It's not too much. The entire budget for 2019 is put at 242 billion. That's if you had the amount the police, yep, the immigration, national security advisor, the DSS, and all of the other security apparatus is asking for. And next one is the component of final is 189 billion. Now, a lot of people will tell you, oh, in the last time, INEC spent less than 100 billion. Why is our election getting more expensive? It has to be so because of a number of factors.
Like?
Now, how many parties were there in 2015? We have 26.
Yeah.
Today we have 91 political parties.
Of course.
Now, these 91 political parties will hold their primaries. INEC has to monitor.
Sure.
Even conventions of parties and all of that. The number of registered voters in 2015 was about 67 million. Today we have over 80 million, about 83 million approximately. The number has risen. What was the exchange rate in 2015? It was 150, 160. Today, even officially, it's $1 to 360 naira. Has it not doubled?
That's double.
Today, in 2015, Alazan, how much was the liter of fuel?
83.
87. This administration came, increased it from 87 naira to what? 145. Is it not almost double?
Sure.
Now, people are shouting. On top of all of this that I've told you, Alazan, Look at what happened in Rivers last weekend. ANEC will conduct by-election, runoff election. They will destroy ANEC property. As if it's not your nice money that is going to be used to replace it. Last Saturday in Rivers, smart card readers were stolen. Sensitive election materials were destroyed. All of them have to be replaced. As at the last count, when we went for a meeting with ANEC chairman in July, he told us that as at then, the commission was thinking of buying a replacement of smart card reader to the 27,000 smart card reader that needs to be replaced. Apart from that, some of the materials, some of the DDC machines that are being used for registration of voters were purchased in 2010. What is the lifespan of those machines? You, if you have a laptop, after 3-4 years, it starts giving you issues, isn't it? Beyond and above that is also the accessories. You start seeing that the scanner is not effective. This one, now ANEC is talking of even improving the software for the smart card reader. Now, on top of this, many of the election materials are not produced locally. They have to be imported, and not just picked from the shelf of Europe and America. No, no company produces and stockpile waiting for buyer. It has to be done to your specification.
Okay,
so you do customized sensitive and non-sensitive material. All of this costs a lot of foreign exchange.
Okay, with all this importation you are talking about of a lot of sensitive materials of INA, and in less than 6 months now to election, and the INA budget is just to be passed, to even be deliberated in the National Assembly, is no call for concern.
It is a call for concern. Look, I write a column for Punch Newspaper every week. If you follow my write-up, even up until yesterday, the one I wrote yesterday, it was still over this issue. There is two major, in fact, three major concerns that I have about 2019 election. Three. One is security. Two is the legal framework. Three is the funding. Now, let me break it down. As we speak, National Assembly on two occasions have passed the 2018 Electoral Act Amendment Bill. The president is here to sign. That means we are not too sure of the legal framework that will be used to conduct 2019 elections. As you are aware, on Friday, 17th of August, last Friday, ANEC issues notice of elections. And by Saturday, 18th, parties are now free to conduct their primaries. But you and I do not know whether there will still be a new legal framework. Where do we go from here? As of today, the funding for 2019 election is not available. But INEC gave us notice of election, or let me put it this way, announcement of the date for election, 2019, 2 years ahead. The first announcement of the date for 2019 election was on March 9, 2017. March 9, 2017. But what did we do? Oh, we still have time. There's plenty of time, 2 years. And I wrote then, I said, look, this is a timely warning for all stakeholders to key into this process. Let there be no argument about funding for this election. But where do we find ourselves? The president submitted the budget for 2018 on November 7, 2017. There was no capital election funding for INEC. in that budget that was submitted. Why? Was it an oversight on the part of INEC or that of the president? Because if I were the president or the Minister of National Planning, and I see INEC's budget, and I didn't see a component that speaks to the planned project 2019, I will ask the question, why is your budget for 2019 election not included? Nobody raised any question. We didn't get to see whether or not INEC budget is part of the 2018 election budget, of the 2018 national budget. Now, as at April, a national commissioner in INEC raised alarm and said, look, ladies and gentlemen, it was on Channels TV, that the budget that INEC currently has is their own recurring budget. The 2019 election budget is here to be approved. We don't have budget for 20. That was April. Don't forget, the budget for 2018 was not passed until May. Or was it May or early June? As at that time, when the face-off between the presidency and National Assembly came up over the over the increase in the budget size, you know, from 8.6 trillion to 9.12, and they increased their constituency projects and all of that. You recall that the president said he just grudgingly signed because he doesn't want to hold the economy down, and accused National Assembly of inserting projects that were not conceived, that ordinarily were supposed to be done by the local government and state and all of that. In the response by the National Assembly, they did say that presidency should not be clever by half, that as at April, the presidency was still withdrawing and resubmitting some of the budget lines that the president sent to them as at November 7. Let's assume that it was an oversight, that as at the time the president submitted the 2018 budget on November 7, they didn't know that INEC needs money. If at April there was still substitution and submission, new projects that were not part of it were being included, why was INEC budget not part of it? Why was it not included? Are you getting me? So there is a complicity somewhere between the presidency and National Assembly. And I don't think this altercation between the two arms of government is helping us. Because for me, both of them are reprehensible. The presidency is at fault, National. And I do understand, National Assembly was saying, the president was, Saraki held down the budget for 7 months. Is that not a fallacy of overgeneralization? Is it a Senate president, one individual will say, I will not pass budget, and the others will not kick against it? But we do know, as at April, and I featured on a Radio Nigeria program with senior special assistant to the president on Senate, Senator Ita Inang, on politics nationwide. And that issue was brought about the delay in the passage of the budget. It was the week after the president himself told MDA, heads of ministries, departments, and agencies, to go and do their budget defense. Many of them were not coming forward for budget defense. And you know that it's a tradition with National Assembly. They just, when the president submits budget, they will do what? They will do oversight. They will also ask the heads of agencies to come and defend their budget. Why did you want an increase over what we gave you last year? That was still ongoing as at April. So the point I'm making is both of them are culpable for the delay in the budget. Because I've read the response of the presidency that said, Saraki held on to budget for 7 months, and when he did that, they could not submit a supplementary budget until the main budget was passed. Was what the president sent to National Assembly on July 17, was it a supplementary budget or environment request?
Well, based on what we read, there is a environment.
It's a environment request. So I don't know why people are talking about budget supplementary budget, because the president said in that piece, and I read it, the president said, I don't want to submit a supplementary budget because, as it were, 9.12 trillion budget is already too high for me to implement. I don't want to bring another supplement. But people are reporting that there is a supplementary budget. What I read was that the president was asking National Assembly to please forfeit or give it part of its constituency project money, via part of it for the election to be held. But I see presidency issuing a press release that says that they were talking of supplementary budget. There are two different things. When you are seeking environment, is money already appropriated? You are saying, use part of this money already appropriated. Even INEC itself has sought environment in the past, where they will say, oh, this money is meant for to give national political parties some money, but we don't have money to pay telephone bills, we don't have money to pay XYZ, because it wasn't budgeted for. We need this money, no, and later on, maybe when there is a supplementary budget, the money can come back. So what I see, Alazan, is a lot of deceit, it's a lot of duplicity, it's a lot of opaqueness in the way and manner the whole thing is being handled.
All right, with all this, even if now the National Assembly approved the budget and then the presidency signed, assent into the budget, and the rule of all this contract and this one is there. They have to publish it 3 months to something, and we have to import this. And even if they are going to be locally made, the contractor has to apply, then INEC has to publish the issue of notice for all the contractors on the national dailies. Are you not seeing a postponement of election of 2019 election?
Most likely. Most likely. And it will be unfortunate. Because it's going to make us look like a very irresponsible country. Irresponsible country. How can we say that we are postponing an election on account that the money for 2019 election is not available, when for the first time in the history of this country we had notice of election 2 clear years ahead of that election? We are not DR Congo. It is DR Congo that postponed his own election for 2 years because they don't have money, and Joseph Kabila didn't want to leave. So he extended his own tenure by 2 years. But this is not DR Congo. This is Nigeria. We can't say that we don't have money for election when it is sheer tardiness. And you know, if you read what PDP actually issued, the press release the PDP issued on July 17 or 18th, a day after the president submitted that request for environment, that the presidency seems to have deliberately orchestrated a chaotic situation so that the election will be postponed. As it were now, today is what, 23rd. The National Assembly, after meeting with INEC and Minister of National Planning last week, said they will reconvene on 27th. Now, which is next Monday. When they reconvene on 27th, what will happen? They will maybe graciously approve the budget for INEC and turn their report to their recommendation to Appropriation Committee. Now, the Appropriation Committee will start sitting. By the time the Appropriation Committee does its own back and forth, we are already in September. So, now, INEC itself has said it needs about 6 months to go through due process of its own procurement. We know we have a public procurement act in place. Nobody is exempted from that public procurement act. You have to, when people talk about budget being too high, I tell people, if the Bureau of Public Procurement does its job, anything that is found to be padded or to have been inflated will be caught by the BPP, because you are not supposed to award contract without BPP certification. Sure. That's their job. So if you are cutting 100,000 for this table or chair, they will tell you that, look, market survey, we have it. This chair cannot be sold for more than 10,000. So we are not approving until you do the needful work. But by the time you want to do that back and forth, time is
it's gone.
So we now are being presented with almost a fait accompli that the election may actually be postponed. Although the INEC chairman said that it's not in their own contemplation, what it may do if they are not going to postpone election is to use their 2018 budget, the normal budget that has been approved for them, to use that money pending the time they will get the approval. I don't know whether that is permissible under the public service law. But you know they will have salaries, yeah. They will have overhead, they will have money warehouse, you know, even money to do by election and all of that will have been, and because INEC is on first line charge of consolidated revenue fund, so his own funding will have been given to it. So from that money, I don't know whether it's allowed, but from that money, what I think the commission can do is to start using that funding that they are not going to use. I mean, you don't pay people until when they are finished working. So you know that the money, the salary that they will be paid, the overhead that has not, you can use part of that to start issuing or getting certification for Bureau of Public Enterprise certification for the importation or for the vendor, to give vendor approval for the importation of some of the critical infrastructure that will be needed for the election. But like I said, I've never worked in public service. I don't know whether public service rules allows that without getting a environment approval, because that is also more like environment. That money that is meant for salary, overhead, by election, rerun election, you now want to use it to do preparation for 2019 election.
All right.
I don't know.
Before we go, what is your take on this issue of vote buying? Who is to be blamed?
Vote buying, who is to be blamed? I wish you read my article yesterday in Punch. I actually raised that issue. First and foremost, we must understand that vote buying did not start today. It's not a Nigerian phenomenon. It's not an African phenomenon. It's a global phenomenon. And it's not a one-party phenomenon. It's cut across major political parties, except those who do not have money to spend. Now, what brought about this issue of vote buying is desperation of politicians to win at all costs. They have come to realize.
What you're trying to say is from the politicians.
Of course, majorly they are to blame.
Who can solve this issue?
Who can solve
it? Yes.
A number of factors can solve the issue.
Like what?
One, you need the legal framework. Electoral Offences Commission Bill is before the National Assembly. Let the National Assembly pass it. Let the President sign it to law. Set up that commission that will have almost the same power as EFCC that can try electoral offenders. Two, we need to do a lot of voter education. And that's by civil society, INEC, political parties themselves. Three is also moral reorientation. Attitude.
Thank you.
Our attitude must change to election. You don't have to be compromised or induced for you to exercise your civic responsibility.
Thank you very much, Mr. Jide Ojo. That's much we have on the program Talking Politics, where we discuss the issue of actually the National Assembly and presidency over the election budget of 2019 general elections, which we discuss with a stakeholder on the issue of election, that is Mr. Jide Ojo, who happened to be a columnist, and issue of election is his own actually area of specialization for now. And that's much we have until next week when we come to and discuss other issues that has to do with the political development in Nigeria. I am Alhassan Bala. Bye for now.